Hey guys, this is Nathan, and welcome back to FTB Beyond from the Creedcraft server. So I'm out here digging in the mining dimension, been working my way slowly down. The reason I'm doing it this way is so that I can get things like tin and copper and some of the resources that are closer to the surface. But I was mining along here and I found a meteor. So that is really cool. Can always use a lot of obsidian, and the platinum and iridium in this thing is going to be wonderful. So I think I am going to go ahead and dig on this thing for a little bit, and we should be able to get tons of stuff. But I do think I need to add this obsidian to my blocks bag. Because, I'm going to be picking up quite a bit of this stuff. So what I'm probably going to do, I'm going to dig this all out. It looks like the platinum and the iridium are going to be going straight into the ores bag. Yeah, the mining, whatever upgrade I put on that ores bag seems to be pulling in the iridium and platinum as well. But so I am going to mine this out, and we'll see how much stuff I can get from it. And man, this just makes really short work of that. I went down by one too many blocks. Oh well. Alright, so I'm going to mine this all out, and I will see you guys after a little while. So I am back from mining. I have quite a bit of stuff in my ores pack as far as good items. So now let's go ahead and drop that in there. We've got quite a bit of iron now. And I'm kind of there's my moss stone. I was looking for that. But I'm kind of wondering what our probability of getting diamonds out of this coal ore is with the dark steel balls. And actually, I think I want to make up a whole bunch more of these dark steel balls. So there's 50 more of them. And I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to drop in 10 stacks of coal. And what I'll do is I'll just see what kind of output we have here when this is all done. So I'll drop off this flint and go throw this. Throw this flour into a furnace somewhere. Guess I could have used the alloy smelter, but whatever. But so I have my unbreakable builder's wand since we got the wither boss fight last episode. So I think I want to head out to the mountain area and start placing down some blocks. Now we have about 140,000 stone that I have mined, and then we have about 1 million stone that has been produced by our igneous extruder. So I'll let this run through its business and we'll see how many diamonds we get, and then we'll head out to the mountain to do a little bit of building. 10 stacks of coal ore and not a single diamond. That just sucks! Alright, well, I guess we'll put this stuff into our refined storage system. But, I was really hoping to get some diamonds. Now, while I was waiting for that to run through, I was kind of paying attention to this, and I see hold shift. And main output plus 150%, bonus output 200%, and power reduction 30%. So I checked on the flint and it was main output 25, bonus output, main output 125, bonus output I think was 150, and power reduction was 15. So these are better than the flint, but they are a lot more expensive. But, I guess that's the way that it goes sometimes. Didn't get any diamonds. But right now, I suppose I'm going to gather up all of the stuff that I need out there at the mountain project, and then I will head out there. So I'll see you guys out there.
Okay, Nath, hi. I've got a surprise for you. I've got a present for you.
Well, that's pretty nice.
If you want to follow me over to my base over here.
Alrighty.
And we'll head in through the front door.
That's no fair. You move faster than me.
And we go up the first set of stairs, and again, up the second.
Alrighty.
I know you haven't seen this, and essentially I was watching one of your videos and knew you needed a load of stone.
Yep.
And so I set something up in here. And if you look how much stone is in there at the moment.
Oh my gosh.
This has been running for 20 hours so far, and it's got 1.1 million.
Oh man, thank you so much. That is awesome.
Because you said you needed about 10 million stone or so I thought that something like this, even I feel that the quantum cores are a little bit cheaty, so I don't like to use them too much. But for something like this, you need a huge amount of stone for your project, so I thought I would give you a helping hand.
Oh yeah, man. Thank you so much.
No worries. So, in the making of this, I actually made 6 of the quantum quarries and 1 of the actuators. So I actually, this whole thing is spare, and you can take it with you.
Well, thank you so much, man. I really appreciate that. And you
can run it up your own power as well.
Yep, and you put the Nether Star upgrade on the barrel, I see, so...
I did indeed, yeah.
So oh, man. Oh, man. Well, thank you so much, man. That is awesome.
Norris, hope it goes... I know it's going to a good home. Hope it goes to good use.
Oh, yes, it will, very definitely. Well, I will move out of the way, and you can take your flux point there. And, I guess I could just take my ring off, too. But,
I've taken mine off some.
All right. Well, I'll have to actually do a little bit of research to figure out how this thing actually works. I have never actually used the quantum quarry before.
There is a sub-touch book in there, and there is a item filter.
Yep, just stone filter upgrade. Well, that is pretty cool. Yeah. Well, it will definitely go to good use. Thank you so much, man.
No worries.
Well, have a good one.
And you.
Well, that kind of changes my plans a little bit. So I have the alloy smelter over here cooking up tons of glass for me. I basically filled this entire crate from Immersive Engineering with sand. So we should be able to get a whole bunch of this stuff. Wow, a little bit of lag there. But what I'm going to be doing instead, I was talking with Apache afterwards, and if I can get a solar panel 6, that should be enough power to run that quarry. And then I think what I'm going to do is set it up out at the, well, I guess mountain's over there. Keep thinking it's over there, it's over there. But then we're going to set that quarry up at the mountain so that we have stuff out there. And also, I was talking with him afterwards, and in order for him to make that quarry, he had to make or kill the dragon. So we do have a spawn or a teleport location to the end portal, so we might have to check that out sometime too. And who knows, maybe we'll go and fight a dragon sometime soon. But, I'm going to let that all smelt up the glass, and I'm going to try to make as much of the solar panels as I can, and hopefully we can get a tier 6, and I'll be back in a little bit. So that was a little bit of crafting, but there we go. Solar panel 6. So we've got two of those. I think I'm going to place one of those here and let that power our igneous extruder so that this thing will keep running. I might actually take this with us out there. But we do have all of those other items here. Yeah, 1.12 million stone plus the 1 million that we have in here. That's 2 million stone plus that. So, yeah, we have about 2.25 million stone right now. So I'm going to take all of this stuff out to the mountain, and we're going to take a look at getting some blocks placed out there. Well, that's too bad. I think the server crashed. And our server admin is not awake right now. Well, this video might be delayed a little bit. So I have the quantum quarry set up out here. It is rapidly getting a smooth stone. I mean, this is absolutely incredible. So all I can say is thank you, Apache. That is amazing. But so I have been trying to decide what the best way to build this mountain is going to be. And I'm wondering if the best idea wouldn't be just to make a large block of stone here and then carve it down, or if I should go row by row, making the edge and then fill in the middle. I'm not sure. But one thing that I do know I'm going to do right away is fill this big huge gorge here. Now I'm going to go and mine all of these ores down here. There's copper, nickel, coal, all kinds of goodies that I would love to have. So I'm going to mine that, fill this thing in, and yeah, we've got to decide how to deal with the rivers, what we're going to do as far as making the edge. Also, I want to mine all of this quarried stone, because that stuff, I have a feeling I am going to want it for the elven build. We have one block of quarried stone here, one here. There's another one that we can't see that's over in this area. But yeah, I am going to get a little bit of the mining done, fill this hole in here, and see how things are going after that. What on earth is going on here? Press shift. And the interface turns blue. Eh, weird. Well, the mountain looks a lot different now. While I was placing this stone out, I was talking with Apache, and we kind of decided for the sake of the server, you know, not having so much lag with placing thousands of blocks at once, that the best way to do this was to build it kind of in a blocky fashion and roughly approximate the shape of the mountain that we'll be looking for, and then I can chisel it back afterwards to refine the shape. Now for the chiseling of the mountain, we are going to want to get it to where our Terra Shatterer will be able to instant mine, and to do that we're going to have to make that Ring of Haste 2. But prior to doing that, there was another problem that I wanted to address, and that is the fact that I had to be constantly filling my inventory to get this stuff placed. Now, Apache recommended that I use the player chest from Extra Utilities 2, and apparently this thing will allow us to set up our inventory basically any way that we want, and we can keep a steady supply of certain blocks in it. So we're going to want to get that made, and to make this we're going to have to get into the Extra Utilities grid power, because we need to make some stone burnt. But I want to start actually doing some building up here as far as the tech is concerned. So what I'm going to do right now, I'm going to head back to the spawn village and make up another refined storage controller, a couple of, well, at least one grid and a couple other things, so that I can bring my items out here And I won't have to worry about running back and forth constantly in order to be able to craft things. So this is now going to become our base of operations. So I'm going to head back there to spawn, get that stuff crafted up, and I'll meet you back here after I have it all set up. So I now have all of my items moved up here onto the mountaintop. I have my refined storage system set up, and I think we're ready to get into that player chest, but first we need to make a little bit of grid power. So I was looking at the various different ways to make grid power, and I think we're just going to make some of these solar panels because, well, they don't require any grid power to make. So, is that enough? That'll make six of them. So we'll just place these down here somewhere. There we go. So now we have six grid power. That'll be great. And now we need the player chest. Let's see, where was that? Let's just go this way. If I can spell. Okay, so the player chest, we need the stone burnt, and that we need the resonator. So the resonator, okay. We have everything except a block of coal. Let's go ahead and put this in here. And there we go, the resonator. So we'll place this down here somewhere. And then we need the stone burnt, so we need, what do we need for stone burnt again? Polished stone. So we are going to need a little bit of smooth stone. Okay. We'll drop this stuff in here. Oh, wait. Whoops. There we go. So now this will slowly cook up the stone burnt for us, and then we can make our player chest. Now in the meantime, we need an ender chest as well, so we need an eye of ender. So let's see, do we have, I think we have everything. What did I just click on? Obsidian. There we go, eye of ender. And then we need obsidian. There we go. Okay, ender chest. What? What? Grid is overloaded. We need 8 GP. Goody. Okay. Well, let's grab a little bit of this polished stone back out of there. And we'll make a few more of the solar panels. Go ahead and place these down here as well. There. Now we have 12. So now we're making stone burnt. And for the player chest, we need 6 of those, or do we need 7? We need 7 of them. So that's going to take a little bit of time. Let this do its thing. Okay, so we now have plenty of the stone burnt, so we should be able to make the player chest. There we go. Now, I'm not sure how this thing works. So we'll place it down here. Okay. So we have a configuration. So full access. Interesting. Let's take the coal blocks and put them back in here. Okay. So, extract only, insert only, no access. I think what we want is to insert only in a few spots here. Okay, so now if we take a conduit, and I might move this guy. I think I'm going to place it up here instead. Okay, so that resets it. So we're going to set all of these spots to insert. We're going to put our conduit here. Set this one to insert. We'll set this one to extract. Always active. And there we go. We are getting smooth stone into our inventory now. Now that's kind of slow. So we're going to have to try to figure out a way to move these items into the player chest a lot faster. So, no, there's upgrades for these conduits, so let's take a look. Here, let's go extra utility, or no, that's Ender IO. Ender IO upgrade. So we have item filters, mod filter, speed upgrades, okay. So that's what we need. So the speed upgrades, we need iron, piston, redstone torch. How many of those can we make? One. We're out of iron. No? Oh, that's electrical steel. Ooh. Okay, so I'm gonna have to make some electrical steel. But if we put this speed upgrade into this thing. Now, if we go down here somewhere, let's say down here, this will work just fine. Looks like I've got some stuff here that still needs to be filled in or mined out. But now, yeah, it's keeping the inventory filled with smooth stone. That is really nice. So that's going to make life a lot easier, but I am going... What is going on here that I can't seem to click on or roll over things? I don't know. But so we will always have a whole bunch of smooth stone in the inventory, and there's Apache. Yeah, the server is lagging real bad right now. I think I may have kind of figured out part of what's going on with that. We have a lot of forestry butterflies flying around spawn, and those tend to cause a lot of problems with servers. So, yeah. Don't know for sure what to do with this ravine. Whoa, don't want to fall down there though. Not sure what to do with that. We could fill it in, we could cover it over. I don't know. That wasn't real smart, buddy. But we have the ability to now have stone automatically inserted into our inventory. That is real nice. And like I said, I still need to make a whole bunch more of that electrical steel so that we can make a few more upgrades. So I'm going to head back to spawn and make a bunch of that because I don't have an alloy smelter out here. So I'll get that electrical steel made up and then I will meet you guys back here. So I now have the maximum number of upgrades of 15 in this conduit, so this will go really fast, but one problem that I have been noticing is that when this thing is active, my inventory is kind of being screwed up a little bit. So I want to see if we can put a comparator off of this thing to try to figure this out. And it does not look like it. Well, that kind of stinks. So that means we're going to have to figure out some other way to have this thing turn on and off. And I'm not entirely sure what we can do for that. We want this conduit to only be on at certain times, most notably when we are building. But I don't want to have to come up here manually every time and go and change this right here. So let's just see. I think insert only. Why? Oh, because I forgot to change this. So let's see how fast this will now fill the inventory. That's pretty fast. So that is working quite nicely. Now it's not screwing things up. Nope. You can see the slime sling bouncing. That is every time that it tries to insert something into my inventory. So if we change this to active with a signal, then the slime sling stops bouncing. So I am not sure how we can turn this on and off based on our inventory. I'm sure there are some ways that we can do it, but I don't know. So if you guys have any ideas on that, let me know down in the comments, and yeah, we'll try it out. Hopefully something will work. But I do think that's gonna be it for this episode because I'm out of time for today. So if you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to give a thumbs up. If you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe. If you have any thoughts about what I've been working on, anything that I could be working on, go ahead and leave that down in the comments. Don't forget about Patreon. If you feel that you would like to help me out over there, go ahead and check the description. The link is down there, and I will see you next time. Bye.